Yeah, good morning, everybody. How are you? Bringing on Coach Marlon, Coach Zen, and we are live broadcasting on YouTube and Facebook around the world. Good morning to you all from here, Skate Sports Dragons live skateboard coaching, and we are beaming out to you guys. And this course today is specifically for Dragon kids who are getting started on level 1 to level 3, and the tricks will be announced to you very soon when Coach Zen comes on. So first of all, I'd like to say hello to Mr. Marlon in the park. How you doing, Marlon?
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning, good morning. So as you can see, Marlon is in a very small park. If you look around him, there is nobody. He's practicing safe distancing. So we do recommend that kids do get outside and do get a bit of skate on. And he does have his mask in his pocket. I know that for sure. So he masks his way to do his exercise, does his exercise, which is skateboarding like you can do. And then he goes off home. So we're bringing in Zen. Good morning, Zen. Coach Zen is in the house as well. He's in a home studio, and it's very dark there. What time is it where you are, Zen?
It's still in the morning.
So why is it so dark? We need to get a spotlight on you, hey? All right, so without further ado, let's get into this class. It's Dragons live coaching with the three coaches here today. Coach Marlon in the house. Oof. We got Coach Zen in the house. Oof. And I'm Coach Hansen. So we are doing level 1 to 3. Zen, what's the program today?
All right. So we are start off with warm-up, followed by a review of the skill done last week. So for level 1 to 3, it would be our step up. And then we will move on to our new skill, which will be the breakdown of a new flatland trick for bonus today.
All right, that sounds really awesome. So, Marlon, are you ready? And we have Caleb. Looks like Caleb's coming in. Good morning, Caleb. Oh, look at him. He's out there and he's skating. That's wonderful to see. So, Mummy's got him out to do a little bit of skate. That's awesome. It's always recommended. And we're going to get into the class, Caleb. So, we're so cool. Look at him. He's got his dragon shirt on. He's got his skateboard. He's got his knee guard's elbow guard's helmet. This guy is rocking. So I think on that note, it's a great time to start our dragon chant. Caleb, can you hear me? Yes. Hello, Caleb. Good morning. You put your knuckles up, buddy. Come into the screen. Let's get a dragon chant. Ooh, so close. Ready? Oh, we can't see you, Caleb. Oh, just a little bit. Ready? Morning chant, we go. Roll in, drop in, Ollie. Roll in, drop in, what? Dragons will always be on top. D-R-A-G-O-N-S. Dragons rock. All right, cool. So we're going to throw this out. And Zen, are we going to start with the tricks with you? Oh, sorry. I forgot. We have a warm-up to do. So, Marlon, are you going to do the warm-up for us? Are we ready for the warm-up, guys and girls? Are we ready? Let's go for the warm-up. Caleb's in the house. Warm-up, Caleb. Everybody's ready for the warm-up. Marlon, I'm going to try and put on some music. If you can do a bit of running around first, right, to get Caleb warmed up. Ready? And Caleb, follow Marlon. Running around. Let's go.
In
All right, Caleb, we're going on to the next part of the exercise. Follow Coach Marlon in his steps. Go for it, Marlon.
Guy, come on, stretching.
Yeah, can you see him? Feel up. Why do you need
this? Circle.
No.
The ring is ringing. Cannot open it.
Okay, Marlon, we're following you. It's a bit of a delay, a bit of a lag, but just go ahead, buddy, and give some instructions. The guys will follow you, all right?
Jason, go as far back as you can. Focus on one point so you can balance. Leg. The last stretch is ankle rotations.
Awesome. Great warm up there, Marlon. Thanks for that, buddy. Everybody's moving, eh, Zen? We are ready for a quick water break, and we're going to come back with the program today. So the program today, while everybody's having a drink of water, what is it?
All right, sorry, I made a mistake just now. So for the recap, it's going to be level 1 to 3. That will be our Ollie Pop. All right, so we are going to practice our Ollie Pop and the scooping for pop shovels.
Awesome. Sounds really good. Okay, so Zen, let's get everybody ready for the Ollie Pops. We've got Caleb, he's a live student. Let's bring in Caleb. Caleb is there. He looks like a big blank area. So we'll wait for Caleb to join us, but we're going to continue on with the skills. Marlon, are you ready? And Coach Zen is going to walk you through step by step. So if you're watching live on Facebook or on YouTube, you can watch the steps. Right, so this is a review of last week's skill before the new skills come in a bit later on. All right, so go for it, guys.
All right, so I'll quickly go through the step, the ollie. So what they're supposed to do for ollie is to pop, drag, and land it. All right, so Coach Marlon can do a demonstration. Right, okay, Coach Marlon, thank you. All right, so there's the ollie. So like what we practiced last week, the three steps. The first step is popping. You got to make sure that your back foot is right on the tail and your front foot is somewhere in between the center of the board and the front scoop. Right, so Coach Marlon can show us a foot positioning. Yeah, so somewhere around that distance. And then you got to make sure your back foot is going to be right at the center. All right, so that will be step one. Okay, step two will be the dragging. So once you pop, you got to drag your front foot all the way to the nose. And then step three, you have to land. All right. Okay, so that will be our ollie. All right, have you been practicing at home? So if you have, you can just maybe send us a video or a photo of you doing your ollies. And then we might
absolutely
be able to post it.
Look at Marlon. He's been practicing. On my screen, he's frozen, and he's frozen in the air. It's like a slow motion. Oh, that was cool, Marlon. And you guys who are following us on Facebook, we actually posted up a great ollie by Marlon yesterday, and it's part of our challenge, which we will tell you about later today. There is a challenge, and there is a reward for it as well. So we'll come to that soon. What's the next skill?
All right, so the next skill will be the scoop from a pop shovel. Okay. All right. So you can see from Coach Marlon. All right. That's the scoop. And let's pay attention to the position this time around. All right. So he starts with the board really close to him. And when he does his scoop, it's going to be just probably about one step forward. Alright, let's take a look again. So he starts on the line, and when he scoops, the board lands horizontal right in front of him, and he's about one step forward. Alright, okay. So the tip to remember for this is to make sure that you are very used to doing the C motion with your back foot. Right, so when you do the C motion, the ball is going to move around in a 180 degree. And when you tap it, make sure you do a C motion and let the tail touches the ground. When the tail touches the ground, the ball will flip over. You'll flip up and you'll be able to do a nice little scoop.
All right, let's have a look at Caleb. Let's have a look at Caleb and let's see what he's doing. Come on, Caleb. Try your C. Pull it towards you and tap the heel. So just pull it towards you and tap the heel. Okay, watch Marlon again.
Okay, Coach Marlon, can you show us again? Then Caleb, you can look carefully so later you can try it too. All right, so it's just a scoop. Right, so whichever side your back foot is, you just use it and do a C motion and tap the tail against the floor. So it will just go around. Okay, let's watch Coach Marlon. Yep. You see that? So there's that little pop, and then the ball goes 180 around, and it lands right in front of you. Okay, how about you, Caleb? Do you want to give it a try? Come on, Caleb. You got this. Caleb, you got to move a bit further back because you can't see your ball. Okay, so that will be the scoop for Pop Shavitz. And Caleb, do you want to give it a try? Give us a thumbs up. Can you hear us? Caleb, can you hear me? Yes, no, I think Caleb can't hear me. All right, if not, then it's all right. Okay, let's have a quick water break and then we can move on to our new skill for today.
All righty. Having a quick water break, that's great, guys. Caleb seems like this is probably the first time that he's actually doing that push of it. So he's having a bit of trouble with that C and like comprehending and understanding. That's quite normal for kids. Don't worry about it, right? So normally you'll need to start off with some foundation skills first, which is like skating a lot. And then when you understand, like you stop your board and your feet placement, where your back foot is, where your front foot is, and practice the scoop. So you can do it tapping. So maybe Marlon, if you could just do a rewind for Caleb's benefit today, because this is the first time he's done the push of it. It's a pretty difficult trick for a beginner. Let's just show him how to tap his board a few times and just get used to that idea of his back foot is in control. And when his back foot is in control, then he just has to bring a scoop or a push. So if you guys could do that, I think Caleb, hopefully you can come back, Caleb. It looks like he's gone down to the swimming pool. But that's okay. Let's continue on. Caleb, are you going to come in? Looks like he's coming back up. All right, Caleb. So Marlon's going to take you through some real simple tapping stuff that's going to help you and help other kids that are watching. Caleb, give us a thumbs up if that's okay. No, he's just shaking. He's just dancing. It's okay. All right, good. Well, I'll leave you guys to do it. Go for it.
All right, let's follow Coach Marlon. All right, this will be a simple tapping activity. Okay.
and then sweeping a board from side to side. Alright, that looks good. Okay, so pay attention to the foot, right, Caleb? So when you're tapping, your foot is pointing to the against the side of the skateboard. So do not point it to the front. Imagine that will be the position that your back foot will be when you're skating. Yes, all right. So that's a back foot position. The back foot, your back foot should be facing the camera. Right, then as you tap, make sure that the back wheels lift off the ground. And yeah, that's a good one. And now you can try to scoop it around. So do a C shape. Yes, that's right, Caleb. Okay, so scoop it around and then kick it back into position. Yes, right, so that is the movement for you to do the scoop. So when you are used to that, I think maybe you, let's ask Coach Marlon. Coach Marlon, how long do you need to do this? How many tries before you are comfortable with the C motion of the scoop?
I've been skating and I got my shove it consistent about 2 years ago and them for like half a year, so I like the scooping so I can get it good consistent.
Wow, half a year to get it really consistent. All right, so take it easy, take your time and be patient. As long as you keep practicing, you keep improving, and in half a year time, then your scooping, your shovels will be very, very consistent.
Actually, and there's a really good point. It does take a lot of time, but for the push shove it, I'm pretty sure that Caleb, you're listening up, buddy. I'm sure you can do it in a couple of weekends if you keep working on it, right? So keep your tapping, keep your scooping. It doesn't take 6 months to do the push shove it, but many of the skills, it does take a long time, like to ollie over boards or to ollie off ledges. It does take a lot of time. And we have a special announcement. We have Shoji from Japan, who is Isamu, our good friend Isamu, the world champion freestyle skater. Isamu's dad is watching us right now, so it's probably he and Isamu. So special shout out to our friends in Japan. Special friends out to big shout outs to Isamu and Shoji who are watching. Remember Isamu, Marlon, when he came to Singapore, right? Yeah, you guys had a lot of fun with Isamu when he was in Singapore showing all the flatland tricks. So right today we are doing level 1 to level 3. It's nowhere near the level of a world champion, but we really appreciate him tuning in and watching us live. So let's go back to Zen and Marlon. What skill are we going to work on, guys?
All right. So the new skill for today will be boneless. All right. Boneless is a type of flatland trick. So maybe Coach Marlon can show us a boneless and then I can break it down into details. All right. Okay, so that was a very simple boneless. It looks just like the ollie, except with the exception that you actually bend down and pick your board up before you land it. All right. So okay, now let's break it down into the piece, into the steps. All right.
Hey,
so,
Marlon, can you turn on your microphone, buddy? Yeah. There we go. Hey, Marlon, you guys go for it. Break it down.
Okay. Right. So for boneless, what we are going to do today is we are just going to break it down to 3 simple steps for you to practice. All right. So once you, as a level 1 to 3, you probably can get this in 1 weekend. And as you keep practicing throughout, you will probably be able to be very good at this skill in no time. All right. So step 1. You have to practice a grab, right? So whichever side your back foot is, you will use that hand to grab. Right, so use your back hand. If your back foot is the right side, you grab with your right hand. Right, so how do you grab it? Coach Malone has just shown you, you have to put four fingers under, and then you have to bend your wrist in a bit so that the board remains up. Okay. Show you the back view. So now this is the front view. So when you grab four fingers, and the front side, you use the thumb to press it down, and you press the palm down as well. So from here, you just do this. So you scoop it, and then you'll be able to hold it. Right. So what we want you to do is, when you're holding a board, it should not lag this way. It should be horizontal. Right. So to make it horizontal, you got to turn your wrist in a bit. Right. So just like curling it in. So you curl it in a bit. You can see that the board is very is flat. Okay, so that will be the first step for you to grab your board. Okay, the second step would be to get your foot off and to bring the board up. Right, so can you see that? So now you just have to get your front foot off once you are ready to land it. So from step one, okay, Coach Malone, can you show us step one first with your hands on the board? All right, and pay attention to his front foot. He's going to step off the board or just slide it off. And when you slide it off, you can lift up the board. Okay. Okay, so yeah, so there is a bit like a popping of the board. Right, so when you pop the board, the nose goes up, you just lift it up together with your hand. Right, so once you lift it up, your back foot should go up as well. Coach Malone, can you show us the end position of how you lift it up? Right, so the board should be in the air. It should be horizontal, right? Almost horizontal. And then you will just have to hold it there. That will be step number two. And for step number three, you have to land it. Okay, from the air, you just drop it and you catch it with both foot. Okay, so catch it with your feet. Okay, step one, step two, and step three. Okay, let's watch Coach Malone. Coach Malone can show it again. All right, so see if you can identify one, two, and three. Okay, so these are the, oops. Okay, there's a flop. And yes. Okay, let's watch it again. He got it. Wow. Yeah, so you can see that once you get into position, once your hand is on the board, you can slide your front foot off and then you can get it on. All right, so bowlers is a pretty neat trick. What we are going to do is, if you are trying it for the first time, you just practice breaking it down into three steps or even the four steps. And then once you can do step by step, you will be able to do it while moving, and you can even do some variation in.
Marlon, looks awesome. Looks like you needed a little bit of stretching there, Marlon. Coach Marlon is giving his best demos out there. Hey, listen, I've got a challenge for you, Marlon. I have a challenge. I have a message that's come through, and we have a challenge for you. Are you up for a challenge? Ooh, not sure, right? Challenge is boneless over those bench seats behind you. So you have to run up, step onto the bench, and fly. He's going to take the challenge. That's the true dragon spirit. Let's see what he can do. Come on, Marlon. Give it a try.
All right, let's watch him.
Oh, we were looking more at a foot plant than a boneless, weren't we? You could probably foot plant off that and jump off. Do you mind doing that, Marlon? Just stand on top. Oof! There you go, you see? So, kids, there are many, many variations that you can do on your boneless. Thanks, Marlon, for taking the challenge. Totally unprepared for that, and that's what we like, because skateboarding is all about expanding your mind. Oh, man, we got that. We got that. We were hoping that you were going to fail because we wanted to tell kids how important it is to fail. And your it was kind of like successful. It was a little bit of a fail. I loved it, mate. Loved it. The foot plant would probably work better, wouldn't it? Bit of a lag. All these people on the internet early in the morning, right? I was thinking, Marlon, that going up to the bench and doing a foot plant and jumping off like the coping on a bowl would be awesome. But kids, you guys can try lots of different variations like that. And remember, just start with the basics first, step one, step two, step three, and then try all the variations. And Coach Jay did one yesterday, which was absolutely awesome. He had so many variations. So Marlon, last trick, anything with boneless that the kids can do easily?
It looks like
he's pushed it off the stand. Are you guys out there watching? Wherever you are in the world, we always have fun. And it's all about having fun and learning. So making friends around the world, put in the comment section, where in the world are you? We are in Singapore. I'm a Kiwi in Singapore. Zen, he's in one other part of Singapore, which I'm not there. I don't very often go there. Where are you from, Zen?
I'm from Woodlands.
Woodlands on the other side of Singapore. So, and we have some other guests who are joining us too. Where are those boys? In the East Coast and also Japan, just logging in to watch us as well. So wherever you are, just put it in the comments. Let's get rid of that. So where are we going from here, Zen? What's next?
All right. Maybe a few variations. All right. So now that we have done our bonus trick, we broke it down to three steps. I'm going to quickly recap them. Right, so step one is the hand plant. All right, so to grab your board, you got to make sure that the board does not slack off. You got to make sure that it's horizontal to the ground.
Yep.
So you can see that my thumb is supporting. Okay, step two, you got to slide your front foot off and get the bounce up. So once the pressure from the front release, it should bounce up. Right. And finally, step three, your legs go up and you're going to let go of the board. And you're going to land on it. All right,
cool. Okay. Looks like we've still got Caleb there. Caleb, are you going to try a bit of a boneless with Coach Zen? Okay, lift up your board. Let's give it a try.
Okay, Caleb, have you been watching? Do you know all the steps? What? Yes? No? Not yet. Okay, don't worry. I'm going to shift my phone a bit and let's see if you can. Just follow me. Oh, okay. Coach Marlon is here. Maybe Coach Marlon can show him too. Okay, so.
Step number one. Right. So in your finger, you got your right foot in front. You're going to use your left hand and just grab the board somewhere around the center of the skateboard. Right. So in between the two wheels. Okay, can we try this? Okay, so step number one, and you can see that my back foot is almost off the ground. Okay, so on the step one, front foot, slide it off. Then it's step number two. Then you lift it up. And then you drop it, and then you can grab it.
Are you ready, Caleb? Do you want to give it a try? So, Zen, go for it one more time, and you can practice that at home. No problem.
Yes, you can practice this.
One, two, three.
Okay, so I'm not going to do the landing because I'm going to disturb the neighbors, right? So at home, you just probably practice your first two steps, which will be two, and practice lifting it up. Right. Oh, a good tip is when you're lifting it up, you try to lift it up as high as you can. Right, so you got to stretch your back foot a bit. So that is the board is horizontal, right? Do not let it drop. Bring it up and somewhere around your knee level. Right. So if you want to be able to get over the bench like Marlon did just now, you want to really pop all the way up as high as you can.
Wow, peoples, we've had some technical glitches this morning. We've got Marlon dropped in and out. We've got Caleb in and out. If you're watching us live, please, on the replay, please excuse me for this. So many people using Zoom in the morning. I tell you what, everybody turn off Zoom in the morning so we can have our show. Just kidding. Just kidding. So Marlon's back and he's doing some. Zen is showing a very good description of one, two, and three live in his home studio. And Marlon is showing it on screen as well, live. So let's go through that again. Step one is paddling. Step two, tap on the heel, pull up the board with one arm, and then drop your board and jump on. Excellent. So there's Marlon doing a couple of live ones. Zen's done a couple as well. Zen, let's bring you back to the computer. And Marlon. You dropped out for a little while, buddy. I hope you're okay. We thought you might have pushed over the pyramid, your tripod for your camera. Here he goes. Boneless with a finger flip, right?
Frontside 180 finger flip. Frontside 180 finger flip.
Frontside 180 finger flip. Come on. Oof. So, kids, keep practicing. Keep practicing. Marlon's going to keep practicing. Give him some fists. Go on, Marlon. Go on, Marlon. He's going to keep practicing that. But we've got to move on, guys, because that's a level 4 and above skill. But, of course, yes, keep practicing until you nail it. Yes, 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 yes. That's the way of the dragon. So the skills Marlon's showing you now are quite high level skills. So boys and girls, on this one, we are level 1 to 3, which is skating, manually, tic-tac, ollie-pop, kick-turn, and flat-on tricks, which we're showing you today, which is boneless. So we will move on to those higher-level skills at 10 o'clock. So right now we're going to bring Zen back. Where is Zen? Are you in the studio, Zen?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Hi.
So we're on to the next part. What's the next part are we going to do today? Any new skill?
All right, so there is our allocated skill for today, and now we have a quick bonus. All right, so the bonus will be a nice little trick, all right, by Coach Marlon. We are going to actually by the coaches here. So we are going to make a quick video, all right, all right. So the video goes something like this. All right, we are going to edit different parts of the video, and we are going to try to do a trick each. So this is going to be how we start. All right, we just pretend that the skateboard is falling from the sky, and we're going to catch it. All right. So
have you got the sample there that you can show everybody?
I don't have it with me, right? But I'm sure Coach Marlon can do one right away. All right. So
yeah,
okay. Marlon. All right. So make sure that your skateboard is not in view of the camera, and you just start this way. All right. Go. So catch a board.
Okay, do a trick.
Do a trick, do any trick that you want. All right.
Throw the board up.
All right.
Throw the board up, and then I'll catch it.
All right. And once I die, you throw the board up.
And I catch it. Then I do my trick. And when I'm finished, I throw the board up. And it goes to the next person. And these guys will edit this. You might have seen it on TikTok or on the internet already. It's pass it forward or pass it on game challenge. And so the boys, Jay and Marlon, are going to create one of those for you guys. So to be a participant in it, all you need to do is put your hands above your head, grab your skateboard, bring it down, do a trick. And then when you finish doing the trick, throw it up above your head and send us a video of you doing that. Once you've done that, we will create the video and send it back to you. And now there is a prize. Everybody loves prizes. A little bit of encouragement because we're home and we're doing all this stuff at home. There is a prize. And we announced it yesterday. And this, my friends, is the prize. Who can tell me what it is in the comments? Maybe you're going to give another one away just for people to guess what it is. Oh, it says it there. It's a – I can put my head inside there. It's a penny board. Look at that. Looks like I've got earmuffs on. And it's a penny board. Disclaimer, it's got a couple of scratches on it where my boys took it to school one day where they're not supposed to. But other than that, it's brand new. So we're giving that away for the best video. Now, the best video, we need to – do it and send it to us today via WhatsApp, or you can put it in the comments on Facebook if it's allowed. Okay, so if you want to send it to us, you send it into the group or +65 8552 8680. Again, +65 8552 8680. So you can WhatsApp your video through to us and we will combine it together and we'll look at the winner. Jay and Marlon will be choosing a winner tonight and we will announce it soon thereafter. So during the week or next weekend. So put your entries in. Make sure you do it today. All right. Now we're back to Zen. Where's Zen?
Right.
Zen and Marlon. So that's a little challenge that we've got today for the skaters, anybody who's watching, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. We've done our new skills today. Can we just have a recap of what we did? First off, we did review what skills?
So we reviewed last week's skill, which will be the ollie.
Okay.
And then the scoop, the scooping of the pop salad.
Okay, cool. And our new skills today?
And today, new skill will be our boneless. The three different steps.
We try and have two skills every time we come on. So, guys, if you're watching now, next time you come on, it will be more exciting. It'll be more fun, and we'll have two skills. And other than that, if you've got any questions, you put them into the comment section on Facebook or on YouTube, and we'll answer your questions as quick as we can as we go. You want to be alive. You want to be coached live, and you can come on the show. There will be a link available for you. So all you need to do is reach out to us on Facebook or on YouTube and we will be able to coach you live. All right. So remember, 9 o'clock every Saturday and Sunday is level 1 to 3. 10 o'clock is level 4 and above. So you need help with your skateboarding. That's what we do under Ask Coach section. So moving right along, we're going to have a bit of a sharing session. We have Caleb. Caleb is still here. He's out there practicing. Caleb, we're about to wrap up today's session. We'd like to say thank you. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for putting on your dragon shirt. Thank you for being awesome. So we're gonna go around and ask everybody how they feel about today. Caleb, did you have a little bit of fun getting outside today?
Yeah.
All right, cool. What would you like to do later?
Because it's raining.
Oh, see, this is, Caleb, you are a real dragon. Even if it's raining, you are still putting on your gear. You are still getting out there and you're giving it a go. So I'm very, 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 very proud of you, Caleb. Proud of you. Very good. All right, moving on to Marlon. How is it, buddy?
It's a good task.
Which part of the – sorry, bud. Which part of Singapore are you at today? Where are you?
I'm at a park. I'm at a neighborhood, my neighborhood park where no one really goes. So I can just be here alone and teach you guys skateboarding.
Awesome, awesome. So sorry, I cut you off. How was today's session?
Doing the tricks, the reviewing the tricks again, and like showing you guys again how to get the better ollie and how to shove it motion. And I just want you guys to practice it at home. If you have time, just go out every day for like 5 minutes. 5 minutes every day already, you will improve already, like really much. You improve by a lot if you just practice 5 minutes a day.
Well, yeah, well said, Marlon. And we will see you at 10 o'clock for the 4-8 level classes coming right up. So over on to Zen. Thanks, Marlon.
All right. I think we did well today, especially Caleb. Even though it's raining, he still managed to find a way to skate. All right. And yeah, like what Marlon said, just practice 5 minutes a day and you'll be super consistent in a matter of weeks. Just in a couple of weeks, you'll be able to be super consistent and you'll be able to nail all your tricks.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Consistency is key. So, you know, if you do 1 hour a week or you do 5 to 10 minutes a day, I would definitely recommend 10 minutes a day. You know, if you can stretch it to 20 minutes, that would be fantastic, because 5 minutes is kind of like basically a warm up. But Marlon's saying like on the actual tricks themselves, I'm pretty sure he's talking about that. So just putting your board down, doing some ollies, doing some taps, doing some tic-tacs, all this stuff is going to be your foundation. And it's just like walking. It's just like learning anything new. The frequency in which you do it is more important than doing it for 2 hours once every 2 weeks. Right, guys? So great tips from Marlon. Great tips from Zen. Fantastic to have Caleb on there. Caleb, you are our sole guest today. Usually we have a few more people on, but they might be having a Sunday sleep in. We are up and we are practicing, so we are going to get better. So thanks, you guys. Anybody who's watching us around the world, thank you for joining us. We're going to say goodbye. Come back at 10 o'clock if you are ready for the you're ready for the level 4 to level 8. All right, so knuckles up. Caleb, where's your knuckles? And we go. What did we do today? What was the skills today? We did ollie pop and what?
Shove it, boneless.
Okay, shove it, boneless, ollie pop. Dragons will always be on top. D-R-A-G-O-N-S, Dragons rock. All right, you guys, see you later. Take it easy. Have a great day. Whoop, whoop. Right, guys, thanks for tuning in today. It was an awesome session with the boys out there in the park. And on behalf of the team here at Skate Sports, please accept our apologies for the technical glitches today. It seems that so many people are online and watching shows in the morning, and so therefore we had some glitches. Also, if you would like to join us and add more value to the program, all you need to do is look out for us, and we have a link that can invite you in as a guest to the show. So on behalf of the team here at Skate Sports, wishing you all the very, very best. Stay safe, stay together, and keep practicing your skateboarding. Ciao.